Hey guys, it's Olivia and I'm back with another video. So this isn't going to be my typical Uber video. Typically when I do an Uber video, I show you every single delivery I do for the day and I show you guys how much money I made at the end of it. And this video is going to be more of an instructional video, like if somebody is doing Uber Eats for the first time. So I'm going to show you everything from how to go online to what you say when you go into a restaurant and all this stuff, just to show you in case you're not familiar with the app and this is your first time starting Uber Eats. So first we're gonna start with logging in. So since it is COVID times, you need a mask. And so when you try to log on, every time you try to log on, you are gonna have to take a picture of yourself wearing a mask to prove that you're wearing a mask. So I'm just gonna put mine on. And go into the Uber app. And yes, I'm blurring some stuff because I'm at home right now and I don't want you guys knowing what street I live on. But basically you click go and then it will say you can't. So then you have to confirm COVID-19 precautions. And then I won't drive if I have symptoms. I'm wearing a mask. And then you click next. And then I'm just going to take a picture of myself. And there I get the check mark. Thanks for verifying. And then I'm ready to drive. And then now, sometimes you just have to take a photo of yourself to prove that it's you because other people can't use your account. Yeah, that's a very cute photo, I know. Thanks for verifying. You don't have to take the photo of yourself every time, but sometimes you do. Click go. And now I'm online. So now that I'm online, I just have to wait for a delivery, and when one comes up I'll show you how to accept it, how you go about picking it up and all that stuff. So right now I'm just kind of in my neighborhood, so I'm just gonna drive until I get around some stores, and when an order pops up we'll talk again.
So here we have an order and it shows us where the restaurant is, where the person lives, how long the order is supposed to take, how far it is, and on the map you can see where the restaurant is in comparison to where the person lives. And to accept the order, I just click the little suitcase inside the blue circle and it accepts the order, and then you will get directions to the restaurant either within the Uber app, or you can use a secondary app by clicking the navigate button. I use Waze and it will direct me to the restaurant. And in this case, we're going to Subway.
So we've now arrived at Subway and I'm gonna go inside and try and film and show you guys what I say to pick up the order, how I pick it up, all that stuff.
CCGEF. Thank you.
Okay, so I tried to hide the camera in my pocket, so I don't know if you guys could really see or hear, but basically I walked in and they asked me if I was with Uber and I said yes, and then they asked who for. I typically say the code, so Uber gives you like a 5-digit like alphanumeric code. So I typically say that because most restaurants look for that. Occasionally they ask for the name, but 9 times out of 10, they'll ask for the code. Because let's say their name is Bob. Do you know how many Bobs there are? 2 Bobs could have ordered from Subway around the same time, right? So typically they ask for the code and not the name. And so basically I have picked it up now. So I have the sub right here. And I'm going to put it in my hot bag. If you don't have one, I feel like it's okay. For my first 50 trips, I didn't have one and no one complained. But yeah, I guess get one if you can get one. So then what you do now is you go to the order, you check it, and then I think Subway did a good job, so I'm gonna give them a thumbs up, but you don't have to rate. And then you click start delivery, you swipe to start, and then it will give you directions either within the Uber app or whatever navigation system you want to use, and then you drive there. So let's do that. Okay, so I just dropped off that order, and as you can see, this person, at the top they said meet at door, but then underneath they said knock and leave at front door, which means that they didn't want to meet at door, they wanted a leave at door order, but I guess they just chose the wrong one. But basically, make sure to read the notes, because the notes will tell you what to do. If the person says leave it on the porch, leave it on the porch. If they say leave it on the front step, leave it on the front step. If they say leave it on the chair by the door, leave it on the chair by the door. Just do what the customer says, and there's really a low chance that you're gonna get a thumbs down or something like that. So since they accidentally put meet at door, all I have to do is swipe to say delivered. However, if it said leave at door, it would tell me to take a picture of the food and then I would be able to mark it as delivered. However, I don't ever take a picture of it, because there's been too many times where the person is waiting by the door because they can see you in the app driving up to their house, right? So they can see that you're at their house. And so they're just waiting on the other side of the door for you to drop it and leave. And then you're just like taking a picture of their house, and it's like weird. Like, I feel like now they know that that's what people do, but when Uber first started the leave a door orders because of COVID, so many people were so confused as to why I was taking a picture of their house. Or like, if someone has like a bay window at the front of their house, they can literally see you, and then they're like, what are you doing, right? So I don't take pictures anymore. What I do is I click take a picture, and then I exit out, and then it'll say, do you want to leave a note instead? And I'll say yes, and then I'll just leave the note blank and click delivered. That's what I do. But yeah, so that's pretty much it. That's how you complete a delivery, and then you just repeat that as many times as you want until you're ready to go offline. Speaking of going offline, there's one of two things you can do. One thing you can do is click the three bars at the bottom right and then click go offline. Or if you're on a delivery, and let's say you're like, oh, it's getting late, this is the last delivery I want to do, while you're still on the delivery, you click the three lines, and then it will say stop order requests instead of go offline. So then you click that, and then when you complete that order, after you swipe to deliver, it'll automatically make you go offline because you said that you didn't want to do any more orders after that. And that is how to do Uber Eats. It's really simple. The app tells you everything you need to know. It shows you where to go, it navigates you, and or you can use a secondary navigation system. It shows you what the person has ordered in case maybe something's missing. But then again, for some orders you can't really check, because let's say McDonald's, for example, they always tape the bag shut, so you can't really check to see if anything's missing. But they give you a list of everything the person has ordered, and then the restaurant has notes, like they'll say, oh, go straight to the counter or pick it up at the back, we have a designated area. So that is helpful. And then the customers themselves have notes, so they can tell you what they want. So literally all the information you want is within the app. And if for some reason something is missing, like let's say you're delivering to an apartment and the person didn't give you the buzz code, well then you can message them within the app and ask them what their buzz code is or any other information that you need. And also, if you have confusion when coming up to the restaurant, you can also contact the restaurant. So most of the information you need is already in the app, and if not, you can contact the restaurant and the customer directly.
And in regards to canceling an order, scroll to the bottom, click the red circle with the white triangle, choose your reason, and then it'll automatically cancel the order and you can move on to the next.
So yeah, that was just this quick video. I just wanted to show you guys how to complete an Uber Eats delivery. It's really simple and it's really easy, and I enjoy it, and I pretty much just get to sit in my car all day and listen to music or listen to a podcast or whatever I want to do. I just like entertain myself between trips. So yeah, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any other questions, like maybe something I didn't cover or just a more specific question you have, feel free to comment it down below. If you want to see any of my other Uber videos, I have a whole playlist of all the Uber videos I've done so far, from talking about how to get referrals and how much I've earned from referrals, and my videos showing me driving delivery to delivery and showing you how much I earn in a day, how much I earn in a week, and all that stuff. And so yeah, if you're interested in those, there's the playlist. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you think your friends will enjoy it, be sure to share it with them. All my social media links will be down below in case you want to follow me on there. Be sure to subscribe to my channel because I make new videos every Monday, and I'll see you next Monday with a new video.